Hello, I'm Amos, and I'm a graduate student at Weizmann Institute of Science. I will present to you a recent work on implicit geometric regularization for learning shapes. One way to represent 2D or 3D shapes is implicitly, as a zero-level set of a scalar function. Implicit representation for simple shapes like spheres are well known, but how do we represent complicated shapes as zero-level sets? One favorable family of implicit representation are sine distance functions. This representation assumes that the model surface defined as a boundary of some set omega. Then, the implicit function is defined by the distance to the boundary, with additional sine information discriminating interior from exterior points. One recent approach for 3D shape learning is to train a neural network to approximate a sine distance function. Our goal is to learn a neural sine distance function from raw point clouds. Previous work suggested a two-stage solution. First, approximate a sine distance function on a prescribed data points. And second, regress a neural network to fit this data. Our approach, however, learns an SDF directly from raw point clouds in an end-to-end fashion. We utilize the connection between sine distance functions and the iconal partial differential equation. Given a well-behaved boundary, the unique iconal solution is the SDF with respect to this boundary. However, for finite point cloud boundary, the iconal is ill-posed with multiple SDF solutions, as shown here, for example. We suggest the following simple loss, consisting of a term encourages the network to vanish on surface points, and another term responsible for favoring solutions that satisfy the iconal equation. Surprisingly, optimizing this loss favors natural simple solution among the myriad of possible iconal solutions. This is indeed the case for other inputs as well. This leads us to the natural question of identifying the origin of this phenomenon. We believe that our model enjoys a geometric version of the well-known implicit regularization phenomena in neural network optimization. We call this, in short, IGR. To support this conjecture, we provide some theoretical analysis for the linear case, which is still non-convex. We've witnessed another important property of IGR, and this is its ability to produce reconstruction with high-level details in 3D. Before we continue, let us place our work in the context of prior art. Representing shapes as surfaces with neural network comes in two main flavors. The first is explicit representation, where the surface is defined as a collection of charts modeled by neural networks. The main challenge in this form of representation is finding consistent atlas covering. On the other hand, are implicit representation. One important benefit of implicit representation is that they easily support the modeling of arbitrary surface topology. More traditionally, researchers have modeled the implicit function only over a fixed predefined grid. Then, the shape that is the zero-level set is extracted by some sort of interpolation between grid points. Note that this is a natural generalization of 2D image modeling, thus enabling us to use successful convolutional neural networks in 3D. More recently, some works have suggested using neural networks directly to model a continuous or even smooth implicit function. Our work falls into this category. So far, we consider raw point clouds as inputs where the suggested loss was inspired by the iconal equation. However, sometimes we are provided with additional data, such as oriented normals at the points. This can be easily plugged in into the IGR loss by adding a normal reconstruction term. And now we move for some experimental results. We start evaluating our method in the task of surface reconstruction on a benchmark from Berger et al. This benchmark contains input point clouds with normal data from 5 different shapes with challenging properties. For baseline, we use DGP by Williams et al., which is a chart-based surface reconstruction method which previously achieved state-of-the-art result on this benchmark. On the left, we show 2 of our reconstructions. The table on the right presents a 2-sided chamfer and Hausdorff distance to the ground truth. You can see IGR outperforms ZGP in 4 out of 5 shapes, often with large margin. An interesting question is how IGR compares to regression when both are fed with equivalent data and trained with same network architecture. In this experiment, we sample an input scan from the default dataset with 250k points and extracted the corresponding normal. For regression, we created 2 samples, one inside and one outside of the surface by standard method of translating sample points in the positive and negative normal directions. Alternatively, we provided IGR loss with same samples and normal. Notice IGR produced considerably more details than the regression approach. This was consistent across all of our experiments. So far, we only showed how to represent a single shape, but another interesting task is learning a space of multiple shapes. We do it using auto-decoder architecture suggested in Park et al. Namely, a latent factor is attached to every shape in the dataset, and then during training, both network weights and latent codes are optimized to minimize the IGR loss. Upon inference, the network weights are fixed, and the latent codes are optimized to fit an input test. We use auto-decoder architecture to learn the shape space of the dynamic Faust dataset. We compare to SAL by Atzmon and Lippmann, which also works directly with raw data. We present a typical test result. Note that IGR produces high fidelity reconstruction compared to SAL. However, it introduces an auxiliary bias due to noisy normal at the fit, which SAL is able to evade since it doesn't use normal data. In previous experiment, we trained on random split, namely picked 75% of the data at random as train and the rest as test. In this experiment, we use a harder split. We train on 8 out of 10 humans and test on the other 2. You can see over here our test results. The results are quite impressive by fitting the poles. As for high-level details, we still have some work, but at least we do manage to capture some fine details. We believe that taking a larger data set with more varied humans would help us fitting new unseen humans. To express the quality of the learned shape space, we experimented on latent interpolation. On the center, you see the result of averaging the latents of the neighboring shapes. A closer look at the faces showed that we are able to mix high-level details of both shapes in a natural manner. We managed to do some theoretic analysis of IGR to support the empirically witnessed plane reproduction property. Namely, if the input point spans a d-1 hyperplane in RD, then the gradient descent with our loss will converge to the correct sine distance function. We proved theoretic guarantee of this property in the case of linear model, in which our loss takes the following form. To give intuition to the proof, we'll show the following 2D visualization of lost landscape. Assume that the input points span the y-axis. We can see we have total 5 critical points. 0 is a maximum. 2 saddle points, which are the form alpha times E2 times plus minus 1 for some alpha, and 2 global minimas plus minus E1, which both form sine distance function with respect to the y-axis. For any starting points with component orthogonal to the y-axis, gradient descent evade the saddle points and converge to one of the SDF solutions. Therefore, we converge with probability 1. For the general case, we show that there are at least 3 critical points, including 0, which is the maxima, and 2 SDF solutions. We show the rest of the critical points have strictly negative eigenvalue, those are either maximas or strict saddle points. A result by Li et al. Shows that gradient descent evades strict saddle points with probability 1. Which concludes our proof. We also extend this result to the noisy case where data is sampled from the hyperplane with additional bounded noise. We show that also in this case, we can find a specific bound on lambda, which guarantees convergence to a good approximation of the SDF. Implicit neural representation has been an active field of research in the last year. Let us mention some interesting future research directions. The first challenge I would like to state is improving the reconstruction level of details. Few works observe that neural networks struggle to fit the high frequency details in signals, but for instance, Tansik et al. Suggests to incorporate Fourier feature vectors at the input of the network, also referred as positional encoding. Sitzman et al. Optimize an IGR-like loss with a sinusoidal activated MLP and report promising results in large-scale scans. Leading me to the second challenge, which is robustness to the noise. The DFAUST experiment, for example, we witness an overfitting of noise in Normal, yielding an undesirable reconstructed part, namely the blobs on the feet. I believe that this could be addressed by further refinement of the IGRs. IGR code will also be incorporated to other 3D learning scenarios. For example, IGR was used in another recent paper by Ariv and colleagues to learn 3D geometry and material of 3D objects from 2D images. Finally, IGR could be used for training 3D generative model from raw data. I'd like to thank the co-writer Lior Yariv, Niv Chaim, Matan Atzmon, and my advisor Yaron Lipman. You're welcome to follow all of us on Twitter to hear more about our research. We'd like to acknowledge our founders, and thank you all for listening. I'll be happy to meet you and talk more in the Q&A session or by mail.